YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. Okay, so if you watched the last few videos, you'll have a rough idea about what stars are, the different types of stars, and how they form and die. If not, click the links on screen to check those videos out. With that in mind, let's now learn how to construct our very own star. First, let's look at the MK stellar classification list. The MK list is a way of ordering stars by spectral type. The higher up the list a star is, the more massive it is. Conversely, the lower down the list a star is, the less mass it has. At the top, O stars have a mass upwards of 16 times greater than our own sun and are blue in colour. Our own sun is a G star and is yellowy orange in colour. And the smallest M stars are red and are about 2% as massive as our own sun. So what stars are best suited for world building? Well, first thing to consider is the lifetime of a star. O, B, and A stars die within a few million years, which isn't long enough for intelligent life to evolve. So early F, G, K, and M stars are perfect candidates as far as stellar longevity is concerned. Second consideration is stellar habitability. M stars, although very, very long-lived, aren't good candidates because an Earth-like planet would have to be so close to the star that solar weather and storms become a serious problem for any Earth-like planet orbiting the star. Large F stars and up give out a lot of UV light, which has the tendency to cause atmospheres to boil away. Also, binary stars aren't good candidates because gravitational interaction would make a planet's orbit unstable. Thirdly, we must consider galactic habitability. For the moment, it has no implications with regards to building stars, but I'll cover galaxies in the next few videos. So given the above restrictions, I have set myself a Goldilocks mass range of 0.6 to 1.4 solar masses. It's worth noting here, guys, that all the following figures are expressed in terms of our sun being equal to 1. Okay, so the first step is to pick a mass from the Goldilocks mass range. Let's call our new star Alpha, and let's say it has a mass of 1.2. From this mass, we can determine Alpha's luminosity or brightness. Alpha's diameter is given by the following. Its surface temperature will be given by this. Alpha's lifetime can also be calculated. Lastly, and most importantly, we must determine the star's habitable zone, i.e. the region around the star where Earth-like planets can support liquid water at their surface. This is given by the edges of this Goldilocks zone can be calculated as 95 to 137% that distance. So in this case, the inner limit will be 1.37 and the outer will be 1.97. For now, this is all the information we will need. Later, when we look at how to build a planet, we'll add a few more stellar details. Once we have all the numbers, we can easily figure out exact figures using Wikipedia and as a result, tell the story of our own star, Alpha. Guys, like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Edgar out. Also, big thanks to the European Space Agency and Hubble Space Telescope for supplying the stunning footage of M66. Click on the link on screen to check out their awesome page.